There are many reasons why you might choose or need to do a go around. The first situation in which you do a go around is if for any reason you're unhappy with your position on glide slope, on profile when you're on finals. And that's a decision that can be made very early. The other reason, of course, is traffic, some obstacle, something unexpected happens. So an aircraft might taxi out onto the runway in front of you and suddenly you're not able to land anymore. So if the runway is obstructed, if somebody for some reason hasn't heard your radio calls and taxis out and starts to take off in front of you, somebody does an emergency landing on a runway, a herd of cows come running across the runway, kangaroos, emus, that's something, you know, seriously does happen at outback strips and even at some of the airports around here. So if there's livestock on the runway, that can be a reason to go around. Or suddenly you approach the runway and realize that the conditions of the runway are not what you expected. It happened to us on one of the outback trips that there were large anthills on the runway. You didn't see them until we actually got right down. So there are lots of different reasons why. Or a sudden gust of crosswind might destabilize your approach. That could change your mind about touching down. A glance at the windsock, an assessment that the crosswind component isn't going to be satisfactory, you might choose to go around and have another go at it. There's nothing wrong with doing a go around. It's a very safe maneuver. It's a decision of airmanship. It's much, much better to go around than to stuff around. Having decided to go around, a pilot then needs to reconfigure the aircraft and change their plans. So a quick change of mental state and adapting to a new situation, aviating, navigating, flying.
So first thing is aviate at full power, plenty of right rudder, positive rate of climb, retract one stage of flap, and we're going to follow the centre line. Bathurst traffic, Charlie Yankee Foxtrot going around 3-5 Bathurst.
Many students particularly think that the first thing they should do is tell people that they're going around. No, that's the last thing that you do. You fly the aircraft, establish yourself clear of other traffic, clear of the runway, and only when your aircraft is stabilised in a climb out and that you've selected your track and you're on course, is it safe to then make a call and advise people that you're making a go around. The earlier the decision can be made, the more safely the go around can be executed. So it's a good idea for pilots to ask themselves no later than halfway down finals, am I committed? Is everything the way it should be? And if not, make the decision to go around early. A situation that I really do not like to see as a flight examiner and an instructor is somebody doing what I call a Tiger Woods, getting themselves into a hole and then showing everybody how fantastically they can get themselves out of the hole. The last thing I want to see or hear is a pilot saying, I know this doesn't look good, but trust me, I can make it work. I was living in Indonesia at the time that Boeing 737 run by Garuda Airlines ran off the end of the runway. I don't know if you recall the incident. And reportedly afterwards, the first officer had said to the captain, excuse me, don't you think we're going a little too fast and that we're a little too high? And the captain said, leave it to me, I've got it. And the aircraft ran off the end of the runway, burst into flames, and a number of Australians who were at the embassy at the time were killed in that accident. It's a human factors issue. The decision to go around early and to execute it safely is a pilot's decision. And so accidents associated with failure to go around or poorly executed go-arounds can be avoided. There's no reason why go-arounds can't be practiced regularly. It's a shame, but often in people's mind, a go-around is associated with failure. People think, I'm going around because my final approach was wrong. I made a mess, so now I'm having to go around. Or I'm going around because somebody got in the way on the ground. And so we think of it as something, a non-standard procedure, or something that's the result of bad performance, or it's an inconvenience. We shouldn't. The flying that we're practicing when we do a go around builds very, very good skills. Every time people go out to do a few circuits just to stay current, you know, a couple of those circuits should be go-arounds. Our ability to respond to the unexpected is only as good as the skills that we continue to practice. Think of a go-around as something that you should do from time to time to practice those quick changes of aircraft configuration that are needed in those situations, to practice your assessment of, is my approach stabilized and is the runway in fact clear and going to remain clear? And even just to practice throwing yourself the unexpected. The more you practice go-arounds, the safer you will be at doing them.